Hi guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another beautiful project. This time it's gonna be medium size doily. Medium size, my is measured about 18.5 inches in diameter. For this project I am using crochet hook size 1.5 millimeters and the thread in size 10. For this project we are going to need about 50 gram of the thread, maybe even a little bit less. Very easy project, actually. It maybe looks quite difficult, but I think most of you will be managed with it. I would like to thank you very much for to all my patrons and members of my channel for supporting. Probably some of you know already, at the beginning of this month I just added another project especially for members, so if you didn't receive any notifications, now you can go directly to the Patreon or to the list with videos and all tutorials for members directly on my channel. If you would like to join to Patreon site or as a member of YouTube channel, you can find all links under this tutorial in the comment section. Any support will be perfect for my channel, and you also will get access to many more video tutorials. So now let's get started. So our doily, we are going to start by making slip knot. Then chain of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Slip stitch into the first chain stitch to form a ring. And we are going to start our first round. Chain of 3 as a double crochet. Then into our circle we need to make 24 double crochets, 23. So 24th is our chain 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now we've got 7 and we are going to continue until 23rd double crochet. So in total we should have 24 stitches, 24 double crochets, and we have to work slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Now we are going to start second round. So chain 3 instead of our first two parts of the treble crochet. Then we need to work two treble crochets together in next two double crochets. So in first stitch we have to work only through first two loops two times, and last loop need to stay on the hook, and then we are going to the next stitch and we have to work exactly the same, 1 and 2, 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 5, then into the next 3 double crochets we have to work 3 treble crochets together. So again, 1 and 2, into the next stitch 1 and 2, and into the next stitch 1 and 2. Now we've got 4 loops, you can finish the stitch. Chain of 5, in next 3 double crochets another 3 treble crochets together. So 1 2 and 3, chain of 3, chain of 5, sorry, and we have to work exactly the same pattern all the way around. So we are going to have 8 groups of 3 treble crochets together and 8 chain 5 spaces. At the end, after our last chain space, we have to work slip stitch exactly at the top of our 2 treble crochets together, so in that loop on the top. Third round, we are going to start by making slip stitch in first chain space, in first chain stitch of our first chain space, and then slip stitch directly into the chain space. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into our chain space we have to make another 8 double crochets, so we should have 9 double crochets in total. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we have to work 2 double crochets together. The first half of the double crochet we still need to work in the same chain space, and then into the next chain space another half of the double crochet. When we've got 3 loops on our hook, now we need to finish the stitch, so we've done 2 double crochets together but in 2 different chain spaces, so as a last double crochet and as a first double crochet in next chain space. And now we need to repeat, so another 9 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then we are going to repeat. So first part of the double crochet as a last one, and first part of the double crochet as a first in next chain space. When we've got 3 loops on our hook, we can finish the stitch. And now 9 double crochets again. So this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. So this is mean that at the end we have to make first part of the double crochet as a last one, and then we need to go back to our first chain space and work first half double crochet as a first one, because we just started by making 9 double crochets. And after our 2 double crochets together, at the end we are going to make slip stitch in third chain stitch of the first double crochet. So at the beginning of our round number 4, we have to drop our loop from the hook and we need to go back to our stitch with 2 double crochets together. So we need to insert crochet hook in that stitch, grab the yarn and pull the loop. And now we are going to start with chain of 4 as a first treble crochet, then chain of 2 as a chain 2 space. Then we are going to skip first double crochet, or actually second, and into the next one treble crochet, chain of 2, skip first double crochet into the second treble crochet, chain 2, skip first one into the second treble crochet, chain 2, skip first one into the second treble crochet, chain 2, skip first one into the second, as again. But as you can see, again we've got 2 double crochets together. So the whole pattern is that we need to work in each second double crochet treble crochet and then chain 2 space. So after our last chain 2 space, we are going to skip the last double crochet and we need to work slip stitch into the fourth chain of our first treble crochet. Now we are going to start round number 5 by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then in chain 2 space 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. 1 double crochet in next treble crochet, then 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 and 2. Double crochet in next treble crochet, then 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, double crochet in next treble crochet. And this is actually our whole pattern. In each treble crochet we have to work 1 double crochet and in each chain 2 space 2 double crochet, so we should have exactly the same number of stitches than we had in our previous round, but now instead of two chain stitches we've got two double crochets. Now we've got round number six. We have to start with chain of three as a first double crochet, then double crochet in next double crochet. Chain of three as a chain three space, then we need to skip first double crochet, one double crochet in next 10 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Chain of three, then we have to skip first double crochet in next three, one double crochet in each. 1, 2, and 3. At the beginning of our round we've done only two double crochets, so at the end we need to in our last stitch work one more double crochet and then slip stitch in third chain of our double crochet. So each time we should have groups of three double crochets. And from now we are going to repeat. So chain of three, skip first double crochet, one double crochet in next 10 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Chain of three, then we have to skip next double crochet and one double crochet in next three double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. From now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. So each time we are going to make groups of 10 single crochets or 3 double crochets and on both sides chain 3 space. Round number 7, we have to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the next double crochet we need to work 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. Now chain of 4, then we have to skip first single crochet, one single crochet in next 8 stitches, in next 8 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now chain of 4 again, and we are going to our group of 3 double crochets. Now in each double crochet we need to work 2 double crochets, so 1 and 2, then we are going to the next one, 1 and 2, then into the next one, 1 and 2. Chain of 4, then we have to skip first single crochet and one single crochet in next 8 single crochets. So this is our whole pattern and we have to repeat this all the way around. We've got groups of 6 double crochets, so this is mean that at the end we have to work 2 double crochets in our last double crochet and one more double crochet in our middle one. So we should have group of 6 double crochets here as well. Now we are going to start round number 8, so chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and in the meantime, at the end of my round I've done 2 double crochets in my first in this group, and then I add extra 1 to the middle double crochet, so we've got group of 6 double crochets again, so as in every part of this round. And this round we are going to start from the fourth double crochet if we are talking about this group, and after chain 3 we have to work 1 double crochet in next 2 double crochets. So we've got for now group of 3 double crochets. Now chain of 5, then we have to skip first single crochet, 1 single crochet in next 6 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then chain of 5. And now we have to go to our group of 6 double crochets. Now 1 double crochet in first 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3, then chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets. And from now actually we need to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So chain of 5, then we have to skip first single crochet and 1 single crochet in next 6 single crochets, then chain 5, and we have to repeat 3 double crochets, chain 5 and 3 double crochets. So this is mean that at the end of our round we have to work 1 double crochet in our last 3 double crochets, then chain 5 and then slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Round number 9, we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the next 2 double crochets we have to work 1 double crochet, 1 and 2. Now chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then we have to skip first single crochet, in next 4, 1 single crochet, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 6, 3, 4, 5, 6, and now 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, then chain of 2. In third chain stitch of our chain 5 space we have to work double crochet, chain of 5 and then double crochet, chain of 2 again and 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. And from now we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So chain of 6, then we have to skip first single crochet, 1 single crochet in next 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 6, then we have to go to our group of 3 double crochets and we need to make again 1 double crochet in each double crochet, chain of 2, in third chain stitch we've got double crochet, chain 5 and double crochet, then chain 2 and 1 double crochet in next 3, chain of 6, 4 single crochets and another chain of 6. So now this pattern we have to repeat all the way around. Now we are going to start our round number 10. So chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 2 double crochets. Now chain of 7, one, two, three, four, five, six, and 7, and we have to skip our first single crochet, 1 single crochet in next 2 single crochets, chain of 7, then 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Now chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then into the third chain stitch again double crochet, chain of 5, then one more double crochet, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 7, 4, 5, 6 and 7, then we have to skip first single crochet, 1 single crochet in next 1 and 2, chain of 7, then 1 double crochet in next 3, and from now actually we need to repeat what we've done from the beginning of our round. So now chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then into the third chain stitch we have to work double crochet, chain 5 and double crochet, then again chain of 2, double crochet in our next double crochet, chain 2 and again 3 double crochets, chain 7, 2 single crochets and another chain of 7. So at the end, after our V-stitch, we have to work chain of 2, double crochet in the last double crochet, then chain 2 and slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Now we are going to start round number 11 by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 2 double crochets, chain of 6, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then we have to skip chain space, 2 single crochets and another chain space, 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then into our third chain stitch we have to make again double crochet, chain 5, then another double crochet, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, and again chain of 6, 3, 4, 5, 6, then we have to go to the next group of 3 double crochets, 1 double crochet in each, and we need to continue. So now we have to make 3 chain 2 spaces, at the top chain 5, another 3 chain 2 spaces, 3 double crochets, chain 6, and we are going to continue this pattern all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 12 by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, chain of 6 again, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Now chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then double crochet in third chain stitch. Now we've got chain of 5, double crochet in the same chain stitch, and we are going to repeat what we've done on this side, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2 and 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Now chain of 6 again, and we have to continue our pattern all the way around. So we've got 3 double crochets, now 4 chain 2 spaces, so one more than in our previous round, chain 5, another 4 chain 2 spaces, 3 double crochets and then chain of 6. Round number 13, we are going to start with chain 3 as a first double crochet and 1 double crochet in next 2 double crochets. Now chain of 3, and we are going to make single crochet just underneath our second chain 6 space. So both chain 6 spaces we have to put exactly inside of our single crochet. Then chain of 3, 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Now chain of 2, So we've got some kind of butterfly stitch, as you can see now. Chain of two, double crochet in. Next double crochet, chain two, double crochet. Next double crochet, chain two, double crochet. Next double crochet, chain two, double crochet in next, chain two. Now double crochet in third chain stitch, chain of five, double crochet, next double crochet, and we are going to repeat what we've done on this side, chain of two, double crochet, next double crochet, chain two, double crochet, in next double crochet, chain two, double crochet, in next, chain two, double crochet, in next, then chain of two, and again, one double crochet in next three stitches, one, two, and three. Chain of three, then single crochet just underneath the second chain six space, so we've got again our chain six spaces inside of our single crochet, chain of three, then one double crochet in next three double crochets, one, two, and three. So from now we need to repeat our pattern with chain two spaces, and now again we've got one more than in our previous round, so this time we've got five chain two spaces and chain five at the top, and we have to continue this pattern now all the way around again. Now we are going to start round number 14, chain of three as a first double crochet, then one double crochet in next two stitches, one and two, chain one. Then we have to skip chain 3, single crochet and another chain 3, and one double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3. And we are going to continue with our pattern from the previous round, so chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, double crochet in next one, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, then into the third chain stitch, double crochet, chain 5, and one more double crochet. On this side, again, we are going to repeat the pattern with chain 2 spaces, so we should have 6 chain 2 spaces on each side, 3 double crochets, chain 1, then 3 double crochets, and again 6 chain 2 spaces at the top V-stitch, so double crochet, chain 5, and double crochet. And this whole pattern we are going to repeat all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 15 by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then double crochet in next stitch. And then we have to skip first in the third double crochet, chain one space, and the first double crochet, one double crochet in next two double crochets, one and two. Now chain of two, and we are going to repeat our pattern as we've done so far, double crochet in next double crochet, chain two, double crochet in next double crochet, chain two, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, and now double crochet in third chain stitch, chain 5, then double crochet in the same stitch. On the other side, we have to repeat what we've done exactly here, so chain 2 and double crochet in each double crochet. So on both sides, we should have 7 chain 2 spaces, then chain 5, of course. And when we've got two groups of three double crochets, we need to work what we've done from at the beginning of our round. So double crochet in first and second, then first we have to skip, we need to skip chain one and the first double crochet as well. Then double crochet into the fifth and sixth double crochet if we are counting in order. Now we are going to start round number 16 by making chain of two as a first part of the double crochet, then double crochet in next stitch. So now we've got two double crochets together. Then we are going directly to the next two double crochets and we have to work exactly the same. So first part of the double crochet, then first part of the double crochet in next double crochet. When we've got three loops on our hook, we can finish the stitch. In our first chain two space, we need to work two double crochets. Then double crochet in next double crochet. Two double crochets in chain space. One and two. Then double crochet in next double crochet. Two double crochets in chain space. Double crochet in next double crochet. Two double crochets in chain space. Then double crochet in next double crochet. So the pattern is actually the same. In each chain two space we have to work two double crochets, then in each double crochet one double crochet until we will reach our chain five space. So in chain 5 space we need to make 3 double crochets at the beginning, then chain of 5, then another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Double crochet in next double crochet and from now we are going to repeat what we've done on the opposite side. So 2 double crochets in each chain two space and double crochet in next double crochet. So as we've done here, when we reach our two groups of two double crochets, we have to work exactly what we've done at the beginning of our round. Two double crochets together and then we need to go directly to the next two double crochets and two double crochets together again. Round number 17. After a slip stitch in our first double crochet, so as I said before, chain 2 we need to skip, we are going to make slip stitch in next group of 2 double crochets together, then slip stitch in next 3 double crochets. Chain 1, then double crochet in that double crochet, so we actually need to start our round from the third double crochet. Chain of 5, or 7, not 5. Then we have to skip 5 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and single crochet into the 6th. Chain of 7, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then we have to skip next 5 double crochets into the 6th single crochet. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then one more time you have to skip 5 single crochets and into the 6th, 5 double crochets and into the 6th we have to work single crochet. Chain of 7, single crochet in chain 5, chain of 7. So before our chain 5 space we are going to skip only 3 double crochets and the same after, 1, 2, 3 into the 4th single crochet, chain of 7, then we have to skip next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 single crochet into the 6th, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, and again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into the 6th single crochet. 4, 5, 6 and 7. One more time we need to skip 1, 2, 3, four, five into the sixth single crochet. And between our two motifs, when we've got two groups of two double crochets together, we are going to skip six stitches. So chain of seven again, four, five, six and seven. And now we need to skip two double crochets, then two groups of two double crochets together, and another two double crochets. We are going to start from the third double crochet. So exactly the same as we've done at the beginning of our run. So we had to skip first group of two, second group of two double crochets together, the next two double crochets. So we just started from the third double crochet. Then we need to skip three times, five stitches. At the end, before corner, we need to skip only three, then after three as well, then another three times we need to skip five stitches, and between our motifs we need to skip six. And this pattern now we need to continue all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 18 by making slip stitch in our first four chain stitches. One, two, three and four. So we are exactly in the center of our chain space. Chain of three as a first double crochet, then chain two as a chain two space double crochet in next double crochet. Chain of two again, so we've got V stitch in the middle of our chain space. And now we need to go again to the fourth chain stitch of the next chain space, and we have to make another V stitch. So double crochet, chain two, and then double crochet. Chain of two, then into the fourth chain of the next chain space, double crochet. Chain two and then double crochet. Chain of two into the next fourth chain stitch, double crochet. Chain two and another double crochet. Now we are exactly at the corner. So after the fourth V stitch, so on each side, now we should have four V stitches. We need to make chain of seven, three, four, five, six, and seven. Then we need to go to the fourth chain stitch of the next chain seven space and V stitch again, double crochet, chain two, and then double crochet. Chain of two into the next fourth chain stitch of the next chain seven space, V stitch again, chain two, then into the next one, chain two into the next, and now the next. So we've got four V stitches on this side after chain seven space as well, and we've got chain seven space just when we between two motifs. So here is the chain seven space where we had to go from the one motif to another, and we had two groups of two double crochets together. So here after V stitch we need to work chain of two, then single crochet in that chain space, chain of two, and we are going to the next fourth chain stitch of the next chain five space, and we have to do the same. So double crochet, chain two, and then next double crochet. Now again, chain of two into the next fourth chain stitch, double crochet, chain two, and another double crochet. So this is actually our whole pattern. So at the end here we need to work single crochet, then slip stitch at the top of our third chain stitch. So on each side we should have four V stitches at the top chain seven, and between two motifs single crochets. Now we are going to start round number 19. So after slip stitch in our first double crochet, now we have to make slip stitch in first chain stitch and then directly in our chain two space. Chain of three as a first double crochet, then chain two and one more double crochet in the same chain space. So we've got V-stitch inside of V-stitch from the previous round. Chain of two, then we have to go to the next V-stitch and again double crochet, chain two, and another double crochet. Chain two, in next V-stitch, another one, double crochet, chain two, and then double crochet. Chain of two, then V-stitch into the next V-stitch. So again, on one side we've got four V-stitches, and between them chain two spaces. After the last V-stitch, so the fourth one, we are going to make chain of two again. Then in our chain seven space we have to make double crochet, chain two, then another double crochet, chain two, then double crochet, chain two, and another double crochet. Then chain of two again. So we've got four double crochets in our chain seven space and chain two spaces between and after. Then we are going to the next V-stitch and we have to repeat what we've done on the opposite side. So double crochet, chain two, and then double crochet, chain two, in next V-stitch double crochet, chain two, and double crochet, chain two, then in next one again double crochet, chain two, and double crochet, chain two, and in next one again double crochet, chain two, and then double crochet. Now we've got chain two, single crochet, and then chain two. Without any chain stitches we need to go directly to the next V-stitch and we have to make exactly the same, double crochet, chain two, and double crochet. And from now we are going to repeat our pattern from the beginning. So now on this side another four V-stitches, between them chain two spaces. So this is mean that at the end, after our last V-stitch, we have to work straight away slip stitch into the third chain stitch of our first double crochet. So when we've got single crochet, we are not making chain spaces, and in our chain seven space we have to work four double crochets and between them chain two spaces as well. Now we are going to start round number 20. After slip stitch in our first double crochet, now we have to work slip stitch in chain two space, so we are in the center of our first V-stitch, and we have to make chain of two instead of first part of the double crochet. Then into the same chain space we have to work three double crochets together, so first part of the double crochet and the last loop need to stay on the hook each time. Two and three, we've got four loops, you can finish the stitch. Now chain of five, then in next V-stitch we have to make four double crochets together, one, two, three, and four. Now we've got five loops and this time chain of seven, three, four, five, six, and seven. Four double crochets together in next V-stitch, one, two, three, and four, five loops again, and chain of seven, three, four, five, six, and seven. Four double crochets together in next one, one, two, three, and four, five loops, you can finish the stitch. Chain of seven again, three, four, five, six, and seven. So this is our third chain seven space. Now we have to skip first chain two space, into the second another group of four double crochets together, three and four. Now chain of five, in next chain space another group of four double crochets together, one, two, three, and 4. Now we can finish the stitch. One more time, chain of 5. And in next chain space, another 4 double crochets together. So in our 3 middle chain 2 spaces, we have to work each time group of 4 double crochets together. Now chain of 7, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then we need to skip next chain 2 space. We are going directly to our V stitch and we need to repeat. So 4 double crochets together. 3 and 4, chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, another 4 double crochets together in next V stitch, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 loops, you can finish the stitch, chain of 7 again, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so this is our third chain 7 space, 4 double crochets together in next V stitch, 1, 2, 3 and 4, now chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we've got 2 V stitches without any chain spaces between, so in first one we have to work again 4 double crochets together. 2, 3 and 4, 5 loops, you can finish the stitch. Then in next V stitch, so without any chain spaces, we have to go to the next V stitch and we need to make another group of 4 double crochets together. 5 loops, we can finish the stitch. And from now we are going to repeat what we've done at the beginning of our round, so chain of 5. Another group of 4 double crochets together in next V stitch. And then we need to repeat. So 3 chain 7 spaces. So we've done first group, then chain 5, then 3 chain 7 spaces. Another 2 chain 7 spaces. So we have to skip first chain 2 space if we are talking about our chain 7 and 4 double crochets. Into the 3 center ones we have to work groups of 4 treble crochets in each and 2 chain 5 spaces. Then again 3 chain 7 spaces, chain 5, 2 groups without any chain spaces, another chain 5 and then again 3 chain 7 spaces, 2 chain 5 7 spaces. So at the end, after our last group of 4 double crochets together, we have to work slip stitch at the top of our first group. Now we are going to start the last one round, so round 21. After slip stitch at the top of our 3 double crochets together, we have to work slip stitch in first chain 5 space, chain 1, and in our chain space we have to work 6 single crochets. 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now after our last single crochet we have to skip group of 4 double crochets together and in chain 7 space we have to work 9 single crochets. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. In next chain 7 space again, so we need to skip each group of 4 double crochets together. In next chain 7 space 9 single crochets again. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then in next chain 7 space 9 single crochets again. So this is our actually whole pattern. In each chain 5 space we need to work 6 single crochets. In each chain 7 space we have to work 9 single crochets. Each time we are going to skip groups of 4 double crochets together, even here. So after last single crochet, we need to go directly to the next chain space. So here we've got 6 single crochets, and in next one as well. At the end, after our last single crochet, we need to work slip stitch in first one, then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So this is the end of this tutorial. Hopefully you like this type of projects. If yes, just let me in the comment section below. And see you in the next video. Have a nice day.